everyone, and welcome to Vlogmas Day 19! I got it right this time. I have been working my little socks or boots off since very late August, foraging for fruit, for our jams, chutneys, and so much preparation, just to try and source free things if I could, like free jam jars and various other things. It doesn't have to be this difficult. It's just, if you can see the table behind me, which is trapping my wardrobe and it's got to go today. It is absolutely laid out, and you've seen it in the last video, and it's bowing, so I have to really clear this today before we have a disaster. It's cram-packed, or jam-packed, as my fiancé would say, full of chocolate goodies, Christmas goodies. It's so exciting. This is what I do every year. And Unfortunately, I've been ill at the beginning of the week, but on the plus side, because I've got a lot more done in advance, I was prepared for it. It really didn't hold me back, so thank goodness. The job I have to do now is the wrapping, actually, is putting the cellophane over it, tying with floristry ribbon, and curling with scissors. It's really curling ribbon, and I can't wait because I can play Christmas music in the background while I do it. So thank you all for helping me with trying to pick a dress. I'm still undecided, which is annoying because I've had two people say yes to A and two people say yes to C, one to B, so I think I'm gonna have to take them all away with me just in case. I felt more comfortable in A because I didn't feel as exposed, and it was a very sweet piece. But C has been in my wardrobe for a long time, and I just, part of me thinks, yeah, I really should just get it out of my system and wear it. Just do it. And so yeah, we're definitely going to meet up with my parents for breakfast on Sunday morning, so I might just wear B, floral print, for that one, because it's very cute. I know it's quite dark for a morning outfit, but then it is winter, so I think I'm gonna let myself off with that one. And the other thing is, if anybody can help me, I didn't realize that a week ago I'd been contacted twice by a network called Freedom, a Freedom YouTube partnership, and I know there's a handful out there. There's probably loads more that I'm aware of. I've heard of Style Hall, Freedom. I can't remember the other ones, actually. But if anybody can give me some sort of insight of what would be beneficial to me, then please let me know. Message me or in the messages below. I just don't commit to anything because if I find something better that comes along, then I might be just kicking myself. And I don't really know how it works. So, and I know apparently you're not allowed to talk about it that much. Oh, and today I've actually stolen my fiancé's Christmas jumper. So he won't find out until he's probably watched this video. But this is also one from Primark a couple of years ago. And I love this one, but unfortunately they never had my size. And we both got these for Christmas. And yeah, I like these. And because I will probably be busy tomorrow, yes, I'm definitely going to be filming as much as I can, but I'm probably going to have to put a Vlogmas of Saturday and Sunday together on Sunday night. So just bear with me, but I can't wait. I'm so excited. So yeah, I'm going to get cracking. I've decided not to do yoga this morning. I think I actually pushed myself too hard last night because I did loads of mince pies. In fact, hopefully I can get to show you those now. So those are my mince pies. Let me just reach in and just grab one. I do have clean hands.
There you go. These are the BBC Good Food Unbelievably Easy Mince Pies. I don't think they're that easy, I must admit, if you follow their recipe to a T. I added an egg in mine and put the mixture in the fridge because I just didn't trust it. It's a very crumbly texture if you work with it, but it is a shortbread pastry and it's very sweet and tasty. So I'm really pleased and proud of those. I'm going to be tying bows around those. So everybody's got these. There is my brother's chocolate slam now. I wanted to put cellophane around it, but my fiance started putting cling film around it, and I just thought, you know, I'm so busy, that's fine. So, and I don't think my brother's going to be picky. So that's his. And this is actually going to be my brother's. So he does look a little bit shy. So hopefully I can try and give him a scarf. I might end up having to donate one of my scarves. And then once I've done individually putting bows around, I've printed off some Christmas muffin mix instructions for those who've got the Christmas muffin mix in a jar. I'll put all of the links to all of my Vlogmases in the down bar below because it might help you rather than searching for all of these recipes. But tasty. And I tidied my bed this morning around my doggy, and I thought I'll just tuck him into bed and he's not moved. And he just looks so comfy. I've put the Christmas lights on as well. And unfortunately, we've only got one Christmas hat on the bed now because this little monkey chewed one of them, and I don't know where it is. I've probably hidden it from him somewhere. And it looks so cute. And every time I see a cute picture of this little fellow, I've got to put it on Instagram. But oh, he's a cutie. Oh, you're a little cutie. Bugger off, Mum. Just so I tell you, I've had a bit of a change of heart with Christmas music because I had it on in the background last night, yesterday. And I'm going to have Home Alone 2 in the background. I can't find Home Alone at the minute. But yeah, I've got it on Tabby, my tablet. And I'm going to have fun because I haven't watched a Christmas film yet. I wanted to watch Elf twice, but I think because there's been so much going on, we've saved it for the camper van. Nom, nom, nom. Somebody's a little too excited about mince pies. Do you like mince pies, boy? Do you like them? I know he likes mince pies. He's already had a couple. Haven't you, you cutie pie? You got a waggly tail? You waggly tail? Watch me mince pies. While it's fresh on my mind, I've told a couple of people in the messages below on some of the videos that I actually was overambitious with. Well, I'd made too much basically, far too much, and I've got a massive tub full left. And so what I'm going to do is just bag them up. We'll keep some for ourselves for camping, but I'm going to bag them up and give them to other friends and relatives that just aren't expecting them. So I thought that'd be a nice gift because they are so delicious. Deep breaths, love that. So hopefully that'll be a nice surprise for them. So hopefully you can see one of the hampers complete, but this is the one with a younger family because of the Christmas muffin mix. And I have to say, after all the ribbon tying and cellophane wrapping, I have got such a bad back now. So I can't wait to take it easy later. There you go. Oh, and the other thing that I wanted to tell you actually, which I forgot again,
was I can't wait to paint my nails later because I'd love to go out and get them painted professionally, but we've had to spend so much money on this house that I'm just going to have to do my own this year. But my nails are a bit short and stubby at the minute. In fact, they've got cake mixture under them. And I'm going to paint it red, hopefully, a glittery red, just to go with my outfits and my lipstick. So can't wait for that. And I'm really enjoying Home Alone 2. I haven't watched it for years. And, well, I'm such a sucker for any John Hughes films. Breakfast Club, Weird Science. I could actually have those on in the background and repeat all day while I do other things, because I pretty much know the story. Well, I know all the storylines. And they're just, I don't know. I know not a great deal happens, but I just love them. And Carry On films, that is a really bad secret, because you either love or hate Carry On films. My fiance hates them. He thinks they're really awful, but I love them. And I love all the cheap innuendos, and I don't laugh out loud to them. And, you know, I suppose I don't find them that funny anymore, but I think it's because they're so old. And you get to see all, like, the vintage outfits and things. I just don't know. I just love them. I grew up with them. And finally, because I've got to wrap this up, literally wrap all of this up, and it's I thought I could just edit a video in the background while I do the rest. Wouldn't that be so cool? Why do I like doing hampers? That's what I wanted to answer. Because you don't always get presents that you like, and I prefer presents that you can eat, so they just disappear. And I have this huge vision of all the families just huddling around the hamper and picking out what they want, or like, oh, let's have a look what's in there, and just all getting together and sharing it as a big feast, and over the Christmas period. So I don't mind them opening them now. In fact, I'm going to encourage them to open them now, because I've done mince pies and they should really be eaten within 3 to 4 days. So I'm gonna go. I hope everybody's having a fantastic day. 19, is it 20? Oh my god, I'm losing track. And I made I made even more chocolate shards, chocolate slabs for everybody this year. Sorry, yesterday or the day before. What I didn't realise, and I'm a total moron, is that I forgot that I'd already made a load of other shards for people of chocolate, and I'd even videoed it as evidence. And when my fiancé was filling up the little tins, he said, there's already some in here. I thought, oh, I didn't have to make two slabs. But at the same time, I thought, yeah, all right, I've got enough for other people. But I can't believe I did that. Anyway, I'm going to go. Give us a like if you like, and subscribe if you want to see more. So Merry Christmas, and hopefully see you on Sunday night with all of my outings. Okay, thanks, bye.